Good morning, friends. We will begin with the next topic, that is reinforced brick masonry. Reinforced brick masonry. So now we have seen the total brick masonry concepts. Okay. Now, if in the brick masonry, if in the brick masonry, okay, let us say this is a brick masonry. If you somehow place some steel bars inside, or if you place some steel mesh inside, maybe in horizontal, maybe in vertical. I repeat once again. If you place a reinforcement bar in horizontal direction, or steel mesh in horizontal direction, or steel bars in vertical direction, or anything in vertical direction, means what? You are strengthening the given brick masonry. Okay. Now you understand, generally brick masonry without any steel and all, it is very, very generally very strong in compression. Whatever load you put on the top, it will take, because the material is like that, it is taking the load in compressive action. But when suddenly some tensile force is acted, or some lateral force is applied, on brick masonry. Okay. What will happen? It is not strong in this tensile, or not strong in lateral or overturning forces. I hope now it is clear. Whenever the load is acting in compressive direction for brick masonry, the masonry is stable because generally it is strong. But when lateral forces such as wind, such as earthquake, such as seismic forces, earthquake means what? Ground shakes. So up in the same direction, the building or the masonry which is coming on the top now, so it will also start shaking in horizontal direction. I hope now earthquake forces or seismic forces, both are same. So during the earthquake or seismic, the building will move in horizontal direction. Correct word is that it will oscillate or to and fro motion is there. So in that case, the normal brick masonry is not strong, it is going to collapse. Another case for lateral means what? Here one side big earth is there, earth dune or some earth is there. Here nothing is there, here empty land, here up to this height. I will just draw once again. Let us say it is a brick wall, okay? Let us say it is a brick wall, and one side there is a soil placed to this level, and another side it is open or nothing is there. So this soil is forcing some force, no, on this body. So this is one lateral force. Lateral force generally means what? A horizontal force. Horizontal force. In that case also, it may overturn. Or in a big water tank you are constructing, no? So generally, it is not strong in that circumferential force such that the brick wall will collapse. For tanks also, sometimes during the storage, suddenly some forces may act in a circumferential way, that time also brick wall may collapse. So under all these circumstances, where normal brick wall is not supporting the load, so that time we use some steel bars or mesh or something which strengthens the body. So that type of work we call them as reinforced brick masonry. We call it as reinforced brick masonry. Now I hope it is clear now. Going to the diagram first, you will understand here you can see. So this is one typical brick wall. What they have done, normal brick wall. Here they have placed reinforcement. So this type of reinforcement, we call it as what? Hoop reinforcement. So this is the isometric view. So after one layer or two layer, for every one or two layers, they are putting this steel bars or steel plates, some very narrow steel plates, in this direction as well as this direction. But generally this is in horizontal, it is in horizontal plane. I hope you are understanding what do you mean by horizontal plane, or what do you mean by vertical direction. So hoop iron is generally in a horizontal. Okay, now going to the next diagram, in this what they have done, they have placed steel mesh to strengthen this brickwork. So it is called as steel mesh. So for every one layer, second layer, after that one, they are placing the steel mesh. So this is horizontal reinforcement. This is horizontal reinforcement. Okay. For vertical reinforcement, this type of work you can see. Okay. This type of work you can see. Just I will reduce the vision. Let's see. Yes, it's clear now. Now, see, during the construction of this type of work, reinforced brickwork, where reinforcement is in vertical direction. So here bricks are made special purpose bricks. So I have dictated these special type of bricks in the first module. There you have some holes here or gaps provided in the bricks itself, such that after placing in the position, we can insert the steel bars. I hope it is now clear. So in this way, the steel bars are placed. Here, the name given for the steel bars is mild steel bars. This is the property. Sometimes in horizontal direction also, we have placed what? Steel plate throughout the thickness. So that is why steel plates have been also placed. These are very, very strong in compression as well as tension. Okay. So like this, horizontal reinforcement as well as vertical reinforcement have been shown. Is that okay with you? So here the reinforcement bars will cover from top to bottom, and just they are made like this, okay, to have a better grip. Now we will go through the point where what we need to discuss. Under which circumstances we should go for reinforced brick masonry, we will see once again. Okay, so now just will fastly we will go, because already these things just now explained, these are the same points in detail I have written there. So it is a brick masonry strengthened by what? Mild steel flats. Flats are nothing but it's not in a cross section like this, it is in a square type of thing. Flat, it's a something like flat. Okay, hoop iron, just now we have seen bars, something like that. Expanded mesh, what do you mean by mesh? It is like something like this mesh continuous. So if these things are used, in which circumstances they are using? Okay, when this brickwork has to bear tensile and shear, when there is a load for tensile and shear, that time you go for this type of brick masonry. Okay, when you want to increase the strength, when you want to increase the longitudinal bond, okay, that time also you go for reinforced brick masonry. Okay, so more strength you want, then you obviously you are going for reinforcement. Okay, when the brickwork is supported soil which is susceptible to larger settlement, obviously when the underneath the soil is poor, so this brickwork, everything should be strong enough, no? So that is why you are constructing a brick masonry using some reinforcement. When soil is weak, that time also you can go. When the brickwork is supposed to act as a lintel over opening, suppose if this is a room and this is a door opening or window opening, above this normal brickwork will not come because it is poor. What type of load will come here? Like this lintel, like this it will come, it will try to bend like this, so normal brickwork will fail. That is why we are placing what? We are placing in the normal brickwork steel bars like this, if possible. Okay, here also we can place. So for lintel we are going for reinforced brick masonry. Okay, is that clear? When it has to resist the lateral loads, we have seen, no, retaining wall, there is a wall here, this side soil is there, so this side empty is there, so this will cause the force like this. So this type of walls are called as a retaining wall. Meaning of retaining wall is what? It is retaining something on one side. It is retaining soil here. Okay, retaining means it is holding something here such that it is not coming this side. Okay, it's called as retaining wall. For retaining wall also they are considering this one. Okay, now what is this point? Lateral loads completed. So now we will go tensile shear stresses. when you want more strength, when large settlement is there, when lintel and sajja, when lateral loads, these 5 points just now discussed. Apart from that, when you want to carry it a high compressive loads, that time also you can go for reinforced. Very important during the seismic activity or earthquake area, okay. Seismic is nothing but during the earthquake only, okay. Seismic means earthquake, okay. During that time also you want to construct a normal masonry with reinforced brick masonry. And very important, what is the condition, how the condition should be there? See, whenever you are using reinforced brickwork, always use first class brick, because they have stronger bond, stronger strength. This is very important. Use first class bricks for reinforced brickwork. Okay. And cement mortar should be dense. Dense means what? A little bit more cement is there compared with the sand proportion. Little bit more cement means it is very, very dense. It is very, very strong. Okay. Like that. And what are the different reinforcing material? We have seen no hoop iron, mild steel flat, mild steel bar and expanded mesh. Okay. Like these things are used. So here it can be provided in horizontal direction. So in horizontal direction, we call it as a hoop iron. Okay. So here hoop iron, apart from that, we can provide what? Steel mesh. Okay. To make it more strong. Okay. So in horizontal reinforcement, generally the term is hoop iron or steel mesh. Just now we have seen, okay, hoop iron or steel mesh. Okay, what is this? In hoop iron, two strips of hoop iron we have just now seen. If this is a brick wall like this, two strip, one like this, second one will come like this. Two strips per header brick. If this is a one brick, full width is there. So that time minimum two hoop iron should be used. Okay, like that. So apart from that, mild steel flats can also be used. So mild steel flats used in the place of hoop iron, it is for every sixth course. It is for every sixth course. Just check it here. Let's see. So like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, like this, for every sixth course you are using what? That mild steel. Apart from that, see here, two hoop iron strips for one header. For one header means what? This is like this, 20. Okay, very important terms. Similarly, before placing them, we need to put the bars in a tar, hot tar. Why? Because for proper bonding with the bricks and surrounding cement, bars should be dipped in hot tar. Okay. And also it will protect it from rusting. Okay. After putting it in hot tar, little bit sand is placed on that one. Just sprinkling. Just if you place this bar and over this some little bit sprinkling, just you need to put some sand particles over this. So it will become a rough surface. So bonding with the bricks will be very, very strong. Okay. So for that purpose, these are dipped in hot tar and it will be sanded. So apart from that, we have what? We have steel mesh. We have also called as steel mesh. It is also called as XMET. Its name is XMET. Steel mesh is like this, no? Continuous something like this, it will be there. So here you can see steel mesh. Just you can see this area. This is a typical steel mesh. Okay. So here how they are manufactured, the rolled steel plates are there generally, and which are cut and stretched. Means what? Steel plate is there. Small holes are made first. Small holes are made in the body and these things will be stretched. The plate will be stretched and it will act as what? One steel mesh. It will act as one steel mesh. Okay. So this is the vertical. In vertical we have mild steel bar, steel plates for every 2 to 3 layers. Okay. So in vertical reinforcement. Now here, what is this? It is provided for every third course, obviously. Okay. Now strips are avoided width wise. Okay, so general market, in market these are the widths, these are the widths available, and these are the thickness available. You can use any one, 65, 70, 230, 300, like this widths are provided there. Now another form of steel mesh is made up of number of straight wires, means what, helical wires will come in the market, okay, like this wires will also come. Okay, so these wires will have the thickness 1.4 1.1. okay, this mesh can also be used, these meshes can also be used. First is what, cement mortar is used, first traveled with the bed, and this mesh is uncoiled and pressed down. What do you mean by that one? Suppose this is the topmost layer of the brick, okay, like this, if it is topmost layer, first cement mortar is placed and it is just spread informally. Above this, that coil is there, no, steel mesh coil, that will be spreaded above this, that will be spreaded above this, okay, that steel mesh is there, no, it will be uncoiled, like this coil will come, you will roll that one above this one, and you will press that one, you will press, so that it will stick to the surface, it will stick to the surface. That is how that steel mesh is placed. And coming to this vertical reinforcement, here brick walls, brick retaining walls, this vertical reinforcement is provided. Wherever you require more strength, there you go for vertical reinforcement. So here what they have written, special bricks with one or two holes, means depending upon the capacity you need to put there, so number of holes are there. So like this the holes are made, and after placing this one, mild steel bars are then placed inside that hole, means what, like this they are going to place. So suppose this is the hole in the brick, so they will put the bar like this, okay, so they will be anchored at the bottom. How the anchoring is done? Anchoring is done by steel plate. What is there? Anchoring is done by the, yes, here it is the steel plate. So here that steel plate is, steel plate will make that bar to fix there itself. Okay, so for that purpose they are using the steel plate. Yes, I think it is very very easy. Suppose, so brick retaining walls are often reinforced since work is cheaper. Compared to RCC work, reinforced cement concrete work, brick retaining walls are little bit cheaper, but up to 3 meter height, up to 3 meter height. Okay, now what is this? For this type of work, again, rich cement mortar should be used and high quality bricks should be used. Rich cement mortar and high quality bricks should be used. Okay, so optimum usage of material is what? Okay, you should use strong bricks, you should use rich mortar, and you should use proper dimensioned reinforcement. Proper reinforcement you should use. Okay, so I think it is very clear. We have RBM, reinforced brick masonry. In that, what we have studied, horizontal steel, vertical steel. In horizontal, hoop iron will come, steel mesh will come. Here in vertical, mild steel bars will come, steel plates will come. Okay, steel plates, mild steel bar, here hoop iron and mesh will come. Okay, in both the cases bricks should be of first class, and cement mortar should be of rich class or rich. Okay, both way it is possible. And we have seen wherever the what are the necessary conditions, when it should be used RBM, when it should be used reinforced brick masonry. Try to recall the points. First is when it has to carry high compressive load, when it has to carry transverse or lateral or tensile force, when there is a soil is highly settling soil, means what, unequal settlement is more, when there is a earthquake zone is there, when there is an earthquake you need to carry all these things. Okay, like this you have discussed. I hope now it is very very clear now. Okay, in the next class we will see with stone masonry, very very important. Please read every video one or twice. If you are not understanding, just give me the message. Okay, from my part I am doing in a detail only, I am not leaving or I am not going any fast, so I am explaining in a detailed manner. Still you have doubts, can contact me. Okay, thank you.